24th.
May 24th.
It's a Thursday, I think.
Yeah.
And it lasts all day long. But it's excellent.
Is it just one, our law?
They're only offering one this time.
Okay.
Yeah. Yeah, I asked about whether they could have two or three, because there are a number of us that haven't had those, but it's only going to be offered for one. So if anybody wants to take advantage of it, please let me know so I can get us signed up for that. So can you check your calendars and get back and let me know? Okay. You know, in keeping with what we're doing with our club assembly today, let me get into the membership. And first of all, let me welcome Kate back into our group.
Yay, Kate!
While we're all working with John, and John's going to do the block party at the end along with all the other things that he does for our club. But while we were at the block party, I had a chance to talk to Kate. And I told her how much the club misses her. And we were hoping that things might be improving so that she could be able to come back and join us. And here's Kate. Could you tell us a little bit of all the things that you've been involved with in the last few months so that we can get up to date?
You're making a mistake. You know, they had the prayer meeting this morning and this didn't get over until 10 o'clock. You know, there were so many long-winded people. And I
wasn't there.
It was very, very, very wonderful. It was very wonderful. I've been involved. The thing that takes the pressure off me right now to allow me to come back to Rotary is the W.B. Wicker School now belongs to the county. And Mr. Crumpton gets to lead it up instead of Brick Capital Community Development Corporation. So we are back in our offices on Makepeace Street, going through the boxes that we took over to the Wicker and trying to find our new home there. We are starting back on the road to building wealth in families through home ownership, and we should be constructing houses soon for modest income families and families from.
And you haven't been able to do that.
We haven't been able to do that because of the change in real estate in 08, which has lasted for a long time, and particularly for low income homes. The value of the homes would not appraise at the cost that it took to build them. Whereas larger $200,000, $300,000, $400,000 homes could be built and they would appraise okay, but not small houses. So we have a home buyer education housing counselor, and she is fantastic and really fantastic. So I'm excited about that and ready to go back to work in construction. So thank you.
Maybe we can make it formal to bring you back in the club. I mean, anytime you come to come. But when we can formally bring you back and have like David Spivey and you raise your right hand and all
that. Oh,
that
really?
Yeah, well, it can be real short because you've been through it.
Yeah, and will I have to get a new
number? No. Neil? No.
Robert doesn't know either.
Codicil.
Whatever legal things we have to do, Ron will take care of
it. Just ask for a new shirt, a new hat. They're getting hats now.
We have hats?
No, he's getting hats.
Yeah, we'll garb you up.
Okay.
We got all kinds of stuff.
Okay. Well, I'll be coming. I'm looking forward to it. And thank you. I've missed you all. Some of you I don't know. I'll try to get around to meet you. But boy, these faces.
Well, she, yeah, Kate was a member for a long, long time. And just had to take a little time off, but now you're coming back.
Since 97, and not here.
This is really going to be an exciting time for us this next 2 or 3 months, because we've got some really, really strong new members that I think are about to come. David Spivey asked me to send him information for Mike Steck. Mike, I think, is what's his son-in-law, but he's the one that's responsible or starting the new brewery. Is that right, Jim?
That is correct.
Camelback.
Yeah, and as things kind of level out for him there, he wants to get more connected with the community. So we're pretty sure that Mike will be joining us, and David will bring him soon. Along with, obviously, we want to get Chad back in the fold by this summer, so I think that's going to happen. So Kate and Mike and Chad coming. And Larry Thomas, this is the first where the son brings the father.
I'm trying. If I can get him back stateside.
Pardon?
If I can get him back stateside.
Whenever he can return.
He's just traveling, yeah.
Did you send him overseas?
No, he's gone all the time, it seems like.
Okay.
Right. We'll try to get him here shortly.
Okay, good. Ben, we had, David, you had a guest the other day
who yep.
sounded very interested, Trey.
He couldn't make it today. I sent him a text or called him this morning and said he's busy today, but he's still pretty interested.
Okay. Matt Garrison from your church would be a wonderful addition. He's so connected to youth programs, and he is going to bring Young Life, is it? Here it's going to be a program sometime in June. We haven't got the date set down. We had one, but then there's a conflict. But we're hoping that Matt comes as a community member. There's another potential. We have to try to figure out with the club how we're going to handle this. You remember I brought Warren Garvey about 2 months ago. He lives in Trace. He's Rotarian, or was a Rotarian out in Colorado. And he spends his summers in Colorado. I don't know why he wants to be out of here in July and August. But he's got a place in Colorado, and he attends the meetings out there. And he said, I want to be connected. Actually, I want to be connected with your club, but I can't be on a regular basis. Obviously, I'm gone for 3 or 4 months out of the summer. But you do so much good into the community that I want to be a part of that. So we have to figure out how we can bring him in. Like, we do have this community membership that we're doing for Matt, and that may be something that the board could decide for Warren. He would be a good member to have here. He's a very dynamic guy. I work with him in our POA in Carolina Trace, and I'd love to have him come back in. Jamie Bowen called me this morning. He's with Sanford Contractors, and he's trying to set up a meeting. Well, he has a meeting tomorrow with the management team, and the management team normally has their construction meetings, new construction meetings, on Thursdays at noon. But he said, I think we can modify that, so I might be able to come. Now, I know Jeremy and Bill, have you been talking to Sanford Contractors as well? So there's a good chance that we'll get one or maybe two members out of Sanford Contractors.
Is it Richard?
Richard.
Yeah, he's the son of Donnie.
Yeah, yeah. Well, either one would be very good, and it's the right age group that we're really trying to target. It's a perfect age group, so we hope that both of them are able to come. How about Garrett? Nash, is Garrett?
Jared?
Jared, yeah.
Yeah, so he's still considering getting into this.
Oh, you haven't got it confirmed yet?
Not yet.
Okay.
No.
Well, we'd love to have him.
Yeah, definitely.
When you leave, we have to work all the time.
I talked to Bob Johnson this morning from Pilgrim's Pride. He's still getting things settled. His plant manager is out. Otherwise, he would have been here today for the meeting. But his plant manager just had surgery, and he's got to cover for that. But he also wants to have us out there for the tour, which we originally had set up for April, then we had to move it to May, and now we have to move it again because there's a hold, and I think I probably mentioned this to you before, there's an avian flu problem in some of the pilgrim plants, not here, but because of what they've had, they're shutting all tours down. They don't want anybody in there until that's set. And we said, well, we don't want to come until that's taken care of too. But I think he's going to be a good prospective member. Jay Childress, I don't know where Jay stands.
Well, I just saw him a couple of days ago, and he's, I don't know either.
Okay. And Martha Underwood, I know you're working on
Martha.
I have
not had a chance to talk with her.
Okay. There's over 10 people on this list, who of which I think by July 1st we'll have five and be building our club back. And as we've been talking about our pots of gold, in order for us to be successful long term, this club needs to be around 50 members and 50 active members. And so I'm hoping that we're going to get closer to that by the time we hit July 1st. Anything else under membership? Is there somebody else that people are thinking about that might be able to join? Michael, are you ready? Michael,
he's got to live here, and I don't know that he's
got to
live here.
Michael's
found out there's other places in the world.
Michael's out running, and Michael, we're glad you're here. What's happening with your running career? Where's the next race, and what are you doing?
He's on hold right now.
No running at the moment?
No running at Coastal. So.
Okay. The warm weather's tough.
He still runs, but he's just not doing competitive.
Oh, okay.
Practicing.
Okay. Well, your fans are behind you wherever you go. Well, maybe in front of you, so I'm saying.
No,
we're behind you. You're, you're way up in front. let's see, a couple other things to talk about. On the 16th, the military concert. David, have you talked to Nicole about that?
I have not, and I'm glad you reminded me of that.
Okay.
Because
they need
do that today.
Yeah, they need four or five people there, and I can't be there.
Right.
So I'm hoping we can recruit another few Rotarians. Arts and Vine comes up on the 12th. Let's turn to John. John, can you bring us up to date not only on areas that you cover, but what happened with the Sanford Block Party?
I'm sorry, I was just listening to some music here.
Did I hear a phone?
No, that was just music.
Just music.
Just a little background to figure.
Anyways, yes, a couple things going on. We had met, let's see, Larry and I had done our last, sadly, J. Glenn Edwards presentation last week, and we actually had a very, very good presentation with a gentleman, Dion, who we couldn't get our first guest, which was Mr. J. from the Boys and Girls Club. He was in the hospital at the time, still recovering. But we did get Dion, and Dion Wingate had done a fantastic job with the kids. He's from Sanford. He wrote a book. Larry had let me borrow the book. I'm on the last chapter. It's a fantastic book of basically self-determination, recovery, and a lot of bad choices that he is now trying to pay back and give back to his community. And one of the things that he does through that is he comes and speaks to groups. So he spoke to the fifth graders. And he personalized it. It was fantastic. So that was a lot of fun. The block party, we had a fantastic time at the block party.
Well, but before you do that, how about the Rotaract update with Patrick?
Oh, yes. So I forget all the things that we do in our travels. So we also did a second Rotaract meeting with Patrick Kelly, Don Douglas, myself, David Spivey, and Larry Aiken. We met over there at the CCCC because we're trying to start a Rotaract Club. The rundown is that Rotaract meets, and Rotaract is for college kids. And so Interact is the junior Rotary Club, if you will, in the high school. Rotaract is the efforts that we do in community college and or college. So we actually did have two people show up. You know, you'd want more. Madison, Yvonne's granddaughter, was there, and another gal was there as well.
She's really a cute.
So actually, that actually went well, and we think we can actually...
Madison's agreed to be that one person, John.
And she did. Thank you, Patrick.
She signed up.
Thank you, Patrick.
So the wheels are in motion for that, then?
I will fill out the paperwork till this summer, until we wrap up the semester.
Yep.
For my sake and Madison's sake. Hold your brakes a little bit.
That's right.
We'll do the paperwork this summer, and we're ready to go to the top.
And thank you, Dr. Marchand, for allowing us the opportunity to come in. We hope we can contribute to what is CCCC. So lastly, we had, speaking of W.B. Wicker School, Kate, we wanted to, this year, beautify the neighborhood around W.B. Wicker. And so if you know where Stewart Manor is, which is Sanford Housing Authority, the high-rise on Horner Boulevard, it's kind of sort of between Stewart Manor and backing up to W.B. Wicker. There's about three or four blocks in there that we had done the project on this year. And so, Larry, thank you for showing up. President Larry was there. Oscar did fantastic with El Refugio and with the folks from Jonesboro United Methodist. Sanford President John Taylor was there as well. We had 268 people sign up for the event the day of. We had about 500 likes and might attends, or whatever you call those designations on Facebook. We had 268 people sign in, and you probably get a handful that didn't sign in. So we had the better part of 270 people between the hour of 8 a.m. and about 12 noon or 1 p.m. And the event went fantastic. Oh, look, here's me. City of Sanford did very well to come out. This was such a success. There's Oscar. We had such a good time this year because we actually finished when we were supposed to, which is to say we didn't have a project that lasted until 3 p.m., 4 p.m., 5 p.m. that we couldn't get done in the time allotted. The fellowship was fantastic. The volunteerism was outstanding. Everyone was all smiles. This is our eighth year that we've done this. So a lot of us are on autopilot. A lot of us are know it's a great event. And a lot of you that have attended know it's a great event too. The neat thing about this event, Sanford Church of God, there's Karen Kennedy, is doing a rebranding of their church of sorts, and now they're called Sanford Church. They had 41 people show up. 41 people from that one church alone. St. Mark's is a neighborhood church that is a couple blocks behind where this location is right here. They were the host church, so they probably had 30 or 40 people show up. So there is St. Mark's United Church of God. That's the pastor from St. Mark's. He was praying us off before we started up. One of the neatest things that happened was that after we had 250 hot dogs and 250 hamburgers cooked and sent out, lots and lots and lots of homemade cakes and goodies and all that. San Felipe had their food there, and they graciously donated food as well. As the event was winding down, the music, sometimes we have Temple Teens, sometimes we have someone come by, David Spivey, his son Chad have played at the event before. They actually, St. Mark's had started singing a cappella, and they were singing hymns. Well, Sanford Church of God, who was in the yellow shirts, knew the music. So they started singing organically. They just wanted to join in. And so what happened then is about 30 shirts of yellow shirts, all Caucasian white people, joined in with the dark blue shirts from St. Mark's, all African American, and they just joined in because they knew the same songs. So after St. Mark's was done singing one or two songs, they said to the, there's a lot of the folks from Sanford Church, they said to the people from Sanford Church, you get up here, come on. And they did. And so they got, and they were like, oh, no, we don't want to do that. And so it was a very, very friendly competition, and the fellowship was fantastic. And I was sitting with one of the previous year's organizers, and I said, you know what? That is the Sanford Herald story right there. Forget about the rakes and the shovels and the plantings and the lawnmowers and all that. That is why we do this project. That's why we have everyone come together and do this. It was just fantastic. Lots of work, beautiful weather. The weather was right at about 70 degrees most of the day. But anyways, thanks for indulging me. But this is about a 14-minute video. Thanks again to Terry McMillan. He's the one that had put this together. But yeah, for the donations and for the materials and for the organization skills and for the planning and for all the sweat equity and the hard work, it was a very, very nice project.
And Terry put not only this on YouTube, but he put the choirs in a separate.
He did. So this is a slideshow. Oh, look at that. Hey, Sanford Hills. It's gratuitous, wasn't it?
Geez, no plan.
Go figure.
Go figure. Yeah, yeah.
How convenient.
How convenient. Want me to back it up? There's a video for this as well, and I did put it to the Facebook page. So there's a video of the event, which you're right, does have the singing and all that stuff. This is just a still slideshow.
Does pretty good on them bushes.
Chet comes every year. Chet's there every single year.
Got that good height for the bushes.
Whether he was the mayor or not, he's always been to our event, and he's always, that's Byron Buckle's car behind there. There's Marshall Downey, City of Sanford Planning. But yeah, it was. Any questions about the event? Any comments or questions?
Yes.
Yeah, it was about 200 last year. We used to, again, please admit this, we used to plan for 140, 150. And we actually got wise somehow, or wisdom caught up with us, and we said, maybe we should plan for 200. And this year we planned for 250, and it's a good thing we did. We actually ran out of hamburgers and hot dogs last year.
Well, it was so big, more. I never found Oscar.
No, you didn't? Yeah.
No, he was two or three streets over.
I was purposely hiding from you.
The truth comes out, Oscar.
I saw this.
Yeah. Now, okay, we're almost on. Oscar, in a quick minute, can you stand up and just tell us, your group did so much work on that corner house on Dudley there. Tell us what you did.
Well, the stone, the lady that was going to bring some plants, by the time I went out to get the plants, they were gone. We went to Lowe's to get her some plants, some flowers.
Yeah.
We fixed the gutters. We fixed everything we could. We had a group. We had 35 people.
Yeah.
They were from Central Carolina Community College, ESL programs, and the church.
Yeah.
We had so many people that one of our students, an older lady there, said, when do we do our house? When do we do my house?
Oh, yeah.
We sent two cars full of people to work on her. On the
oh, you did do it?
Yes, we did.
Oh, that's sweet.
Wow.
That was sweet. So anyways, with the same, you know, upbeat, glib personalities that we share in these meetings, we did an awful, awful lot of work, and everyone was only happy to do it. So that, I guess that's the definition of volunteerism right there.
John, you did a terrific job organizing.
There's Larry. There's Larry.
Follow up.
He did great job organizing.
Actually, he didn't know how to start it.
Go turn around. Okay. And now we need to get into the drawings. Oh, just to bring you up to date, you know, we had that Sister City program the other day, and we had hoped that that group would come in next week, but they ran into some difficulties with the municipality down in Mexico. So it'll be delayed a few weeks, but they will be coming. And I'm really looking forward to that, because it's just another example of how Rotary makes a lot of stuff happen. It's not just internal inside Rotary. We just open it up for the world, and now we've got a sister city relationship in Mexico with Sanford because of Rotary. So let's do, what do you want to do first?
Can we get Michael up there to draw?
Yeah.
Let's do that.
Yeah.
Your name's in there.
Yeah.
It's okay to draw your own name.
Pick us out a winner, Michael.
And
one little ticket there.
Nash could dig in and find something in there. Or
yes.
Last four.
Maybe
last four.
Last four?
Yeah. Yep. Last four numbers.
Okay. 9188. Here it is.
Go Go ahead, Larry.
We earned $34 today, $17 to Polio Plus, and $17 to
Larry.
No, put it to Polio.
Put it to Polio Plus. Okay, way to go, Larry.
Stick your arm in there, dig around, and find your heart. And don't be looking at it. Can't be looking for your stuff.
Yeah.
Okay. This is Drew Lukes.
Lucas.
Wouldn't Drew want to donate it to Rotary? That come on in.
All right, the rule is it has to go back in. Because we didn't have a meeting last week, so we're doing two this week.
Well, we really did have a meeting.
Well, we didn't have a meeting here.
Right.
Excuse me. Thank you for the correction.
You missed it. We missed you.
Couldn't be corrected.
Yeah, he had 25 family guys.
All right, give me another card, young man.
I'm not looking now.
All right. Molly Jensen.
Oh, again.
That's good.
All
thank
right.
you, sir.
You're thanks. Welcome. Now, just prior to the meeting, about a half hour, an hour before the meeting, Chris called and said, Larry, do you think you could talk for a half hour? No, the question was, I had
to eat the half hour.
That's not a rule.
You're not done yet. Hold on a second.
Okay.
I need to announce that we have two Century ticket sellers. The quiet one up front has gone to 103, and Mr. Van has turned in his 100th ticket today.
It wouldn't have done it without my 25 family members that I dragged to run
well,
to the play.
Thank goodness there's a large family of filaments around the world.
They're all expecting to win, too, so I don't know how I'm going to.
We want to thank Brett for joining us today. And we found out something very interesting. You know, Nash has got a new agency over in Holly Springs. And so she's a member here and will be commuting to Holly Springs. Last night, we found out the new general manager for Carolina Trace, who's really a good guy. I'm really impressed to listen to him talk to our group last night. Garth Alcada, his name is. He was originally a Rotarian in Holly Springs and will be working in Sanford and was down in Florida for several years at a very large complex down in Florida, but wanted to come back to North Carolina. So what's gonna happen is he's gonna live there and work here. And Nash is going to live here and work there. So they're going to pass one another on a regular basis. And Garth wants to be connected with us. We're trying to figure out how to do that. And I think the corporate membership will work for him. Because he wants to do makeups here, but he definitely wants to have his membership that he had for 10 years at Holly Springs. So I believe the half hour is filled. Michael, thank you very much for coming and doing the drawing. We can't tell you how much. We're so happy to have you back here.
Thank you, Larry.
And next week, can we make it formal? I'll tell David.
Yeah, that
okay.
sounds good.
We'll do that. And we'll get the hat and all that other stuff. And the codicil. We'll get an updated codicil, right, Brown? No, we don't need it. Okay. And for, hey, I gotta leave the four-way test.
Absolutely.
Four-way test are the things that we think they're gonna do. First,